Waste. Everyone's talking about it. From the harmful effects of plastic in our oceans to the litter in our streets and parks. But what about other types of waste? Like the waste that goes down our sinks, toilets and drains. This wastewater makes its way from thousands of homes like yours to wastewater treatment plants like Seafield here in Edinburgh. On average, Seafield treats enough wastewater to fill over 120 Olympic-sized swimming pools every day. So what do we do with it? First, we take out all of the things that shouldn't be in there. Sadly, a lot of this has been deliberately flushed down toilets or is rinsed down the kitchen sink. Things like baby wipes, sanitary products and nappies, or leftover food and oil. This can cause real problems later on in the treatment process. So the rules are, remember the three P's and only flush pee, poo and toilet paper in the bathroom. And definitely don't put fats, oils and grease down the sink. Once all the things that shouldn't be there have been removed, the flow arrives in our primary settlement tanks. Any organic solids will settle at the bottom of the tanks, leaving a clearer liquid at the surface. From here, the treatment process splits into two parts. The liquid goes in one direction, the sludge in another. Sludge is the name we give to things that have settled at the bottom of the tanks. The liquid heads off for a biological treatment. This completely natural process injects oxygen into the tanks where it reacts with bacteria and starts to feed on any harmful organic material that's still present in the liquid. When most of this has been eaten away, the liquid goes to the final settlement tanks, where it's allowed to settle. Once a muddy, murky brown, it has been transformed into a clear liquid that meets very tough environmental standards. So now it can be sent down a 1.8 kilometre long pipe out to sea. But let's not forget the sludge, which is mostly comprised of poo and other organic material. The sludge is still very runny at this stage, so as much of the water as possible is removed through a dewatering and thickening process. Any water removed is sent back for further treatment. Then the remaining thickened sludge heads off to our thermal hydrolysis units. These act like giant pressure cookers, pasteurizing the sludge by boiling it to kill off harmful bacteria, in much the same way as milk is pasteurized. Once it has been dried out, a fully recycled, safe fertilizer product is produced that meets the highest quality industry standards and can be used in agriculture. Also, during this process, something else very important happens. The sludge is treated in our digester units. Much like what goes on in our stomachs, when organic material is broken down, it gives off a biogas. At Seafield, we convert this into electricity. We use this electricity to power our whole site, and sometimes we even have enough electricity to export back to the national grid and power people's homes. Homes just like yours. So next time you switch on the lights in your house, remember, that electricity might just have started life as something that went down your sink, toilet, or drain a few days before. And don't forget, follow our kitchen and bathroom rules, because it takes every one of us working together to make all this happen. Veolia, resourcing the world.